Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel Car Infos and Suggestions. So today I am going to demonstrate the difference of intensity between HID, LED and halogen bulbs. So this is the Royal Enfield Thunderbird. This powers HID, that is high intensity discharge lamp. So it looks extremely powerful. This is the intensity. So this is Bajaj NS200. Which comes under Pulsar brand. So this features an LED bulb, and this is Vespa VXL 150, and this features a normal halogen bulb. So all three vehicles are running under DC current, which is direct current. So guys, here is the Vespa VXL 150, which features an halogen bulb. So now I'll demonstrate the intensity of Vespa bulb. So this is the spread of the halogen bulb, which runs on DC current, which is a direct current. So this is the low beam. As you can see, it is moderate, neither too bright nor too low. So now I'll feature the high beam. So actually the headlight setup is high, so you can see that there is a blind spot in here. So while cruising on the highway or using it anywhere in dark lights, so this might not be the best option. So I recommend it to switch into any other high intensity bulbs. So I have to get the position of this bulb right, but it's okay for city usage. So this is the intensity of Vespa bulb. So this is the vehicle. Yeah. Okay, now I'll next show you the LED bulb. Guys, this is a Bajaj Pulsar NS200. Actually, the owner of this bike has put an LED aftermarket bulb into this bike. So now I'll show the intensity of this particular bike. So now it's in low beam, right? Low beam then. Now it's in low beam, and this features on DC current. So now I'll switch to high beam. See the intensity. So as you can see that LEDs usually tend to scatter a lot. So you can see the light is all over the place, and due to some quality bulbs used in this particular motorcycle, this particular LED bulb is quite useful in highways also. So the difference between high beam and low beam is not much. As you can see, this is the low beam, and watch carefully the high beam. Okay, see, this is the high beam. So literally there is no difference between low beam and high beam. Only thing is the intensity keeps on increasing. So due to the tuning of this particular bulb, the visibility of this particular bulb is pretty good. So I can recommend this particular bulb. After the discussion about the bulb with the owner, this particular model consists of the night eye bulb. You can get a pair of night eye bulb for rupees 2500. You can order it in Amazon as well as Flipkart, okay? So this is the intensity of night eye bulb. It's quite good, guys. I can recommend it, okay? So guys, now it's the Royal Enfield Thunderbird. This features an high intensity discharge bulb. As you can see, the minus of this bulb is it goes to full intensity after a particular period of time. So now you can see the difference. This is in low beam. When I switch it to high beam, see, there is a darkness, right? It takes 10 to 15 seconds to come to full intensity. You can see it, right? See the now the bulb has come to full intensity. So this is the disadvantage of HID bulbs, but it's extremely powerful and the best among the three. But HID bulbs do not suit to all bikes. Since Royal Enfield use a larger battery, I can recommend HID bulbs for Royal Enfield motorcycle. Actually, after an intense usage of this bulb, you can see the battery indicator here, right? So this indicates that it's harming the battery more, okay, as compared to LEDs and halogens. So I won't recommend to use this longly, okay? So this is the intensity. As you can see from the video, despite having the projector, has a sharp cutoff, so it gives a clear vision. But LED tends to scatter a lot, but it has a particular focus this also has particular focus, but when I switch it to high beam, this doesn't scatter, so you cannot see the sides. Okay, LEDs tend to illuminate all the side, but this focuses on a particular point. So I recommend a pair of auxiliary lamps also for the illumination of side roads. Okay, so this is the intensity of HID bulb, and this is the view of the bikes. Okay, so that's it. Conclude the video by saying that for city usage, its usage of halogen is more than enough. For LEDs tend to be energy efficient, and HIDs for long highway cruising. Okay, so this is the video of my headlight comparison. Okay, stay safe, stay tuned. Thank you.